Hi everyone, how are you today? Welcome back. And if you are new here, welcome to my channel, where you can learn the real-world coding experience. And this is Hong, the coding expert. If you want to pass any coding exam, to start your coding career, or if you are already holding a coding credential, working in the field, and want to learn more in order to advance your coding profession, then you are in the right place. Last week, you had a chance to learn the anatomy and physiology of the respiratory system. So this week, I'm going to show you how to code surgeries and procedures relating to this system. Do you see how I prepare you step by step? You need to know the anatomy before you can code them correctly. Passing the exam is your first step. Your second step is to prepare yourself for the real world of coding and also for your career advancements. Instead of jamming everything in your head, it will be very difficult for you to retain the information. I create my training video by the system so that it will be much easier for you to learn, to digest, and to retain all the information. Today's topic is CPC, COC, Ccs-P exam prep in 2021, the respiratory system. You have a chance to code case studies that you need to know for the exam and also for work. Alright, without further ado, let's get started. Question number one. What is the correct CPD code to use for this procedure? Initial control of epitaxis, posterior, by packing off the posterior nails. I will book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPD book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. Basically, to control a nosebleed, the physician will apply electrical or chemical coagulation, packing materials, or an inflatable balloon to the anterior or posterior section of the nose. That said, when you call this type of procedure, I want you to keep an eye on the side, anterior or posterior, and if this is an initial or subsequent treatment. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term, epitaxis. It will direct you to see hemorrhage, control, nasal, and then initial. Follow the instruction. It will give you just one code, 30905. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list. And here it is. 30905, control of nasal hemorrhage, posterior with posterior nasal packs and or cauteri, any method initial. And this is the right code to use for this procedure based on the code description. That said, the correct answer for this question is 30905. Before we move on to the next case, my advice to you is that when you are reviewing this case with me, please make sure that you highlight these main terms in your CPT book so that when you call this type of procedures in the future, you will come to this page and the highlighted text will stand out and it will make it easier for you to locate the code. Question number two. What is the correct CPD code to use for this procedure? Total laryngectomy with left radical neck dissection. Ectomy means a surgical removal, so laryngectomy means surgical removal of the larynx or voice box. Total laryngectomy is generally done for advanced cancer of the larynx or hypopharynx or advanced thyroid cancer invading the larynx. I put on the short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term, laryngectomy, total. It gives you two codes, 31360 and 31365. Your next step is to double-check these two codes in the tabular list and hear what you got. 31360, laryngectomy, total. With our radical neck dissection, and 31365. This is an identical, so it includes all the information from the cover above, 31360, which is the parent code, except it also includes the radical neck dissection. Review of the available codes indicate that 31365 is the right code to use for a total laryngectomy with radical neck dissection or removal of regional lymph nodes. I don't want you to be confused between an identical and an add-on code. An add-on code must have a blood site in front, and therefore it must be reported with the primary code. On the other hand, an identical is a standalone code. To save space in CBT, they don't want to print the entire text from the code above, so they create the identicals which can be assigned without any additional code. Having said that, the correct answer for this question is 31365. Question number 3. What is the correct CBD code to use for this procedure? Thoracoscopy of the pericardial sac with biopsy. I book on a short 30 seconds music while waiting for you to open your CBT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CBT book, you look under the main term, thoracoscopy, diagnostic with biopsy, resulting in code 32604, 32606, and a code range 32607 to 32609. Your next step is always to check these codes in the tabular list and review of this code indicate that 32601, thoracoscopy, diagnostic, lungs, pericardial sac, mediastinal or pleural space without biopsy. And 32604, this is an identical, so it includes all information from the code above, 32601, which is the parent code, except this for pericardial sac with biopsy. And this is the right code to use for this surgical procedure. That said, the correct answer for this question is 32604. Question number 4. What is the correct CBD code to use for this procedure? Right lung upper lobectomy. Before we start, I just want you to know the difference between lobectomy and pneumonectomy. You already learned the anatomy of the lungs from my A&P video, so you know the left lung has two lobes and the right lung has three lobes. And lobectomy is the surgical removal of a lobe of a lung. Versus pneumonectomy is the surgical removal one of your lungs. On the same note, what is different between weft recession and segmentectomy? Weft recession is the surgical removal of a weft shape or triangle shaped mass of tissue. Versus segmentectomy refers to removing a section of a lobe of the lung. It also called segmental recession. Now, go back to your question. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Right lung upper lobectomy. I book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term, lobectomy, lung. It gives you a code range 324A0 to 324A2. Your next step is to check these codes in the tabular list and review of this code indicate that 324A0, removal of lung, other than pneumonectomy, single lobe, or lobectomy. And 324A2, this is unidentical, so it includes all information from the code above, 324A0, which is the parent code, except this is for removal of two lobes, or by lobectomy. Based on the question, only one lobe is removed, which is the right upper lobe, so the correct code to you in this case is 324A0. Question number 5. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Functional endoscopic sinus surgery, FESS, FEST, with frontal sinus polyps removal. This is a new technique. Before FEST, the surgeon has to cut directly into the outside of the face to find the problem and remove it. It increases the risk of infection and recovery time. Today, functional endoscopic sinus surgery, FEST, is one of the most common surgical methods to treat chronic sinus infection. It is more precise, less invasive way to open the sinuses. In a FEST procedure, the surgeon uses a magnifying endoscope to see and remove affected tissue and bone. I book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term sinuses, frontal, exploration, with nasal, sinus endoscopy. It gives you just one code, 31276. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list. 31276, nasal, sinus, endoscopy, surgical, with frontal sinus exploration, including removal of tissues from the frontal sinus when performed. There is no other code for you to check, and this code is the right code to use for this procedure. So the correct answer for this question is 31276. Question number 6. What is the correct CPT code to use for this procedure? Bronchoscopy with transbronchial lung biopsy. Before we start, I just want you to know that laryngoscopy and bronchoscopy are two procedures that may be done together. A laryngoscopy. Look at the throat and larynx or vocal cords. Bronchoscopy. Looks at the airways including the trachea or windpipe, bronchi and bronchioles. These procedures can be used to diagnose and treat certain problems. They can also be used to remove objects stuck in your throat or airway. A tissue sample may be taken for biopsy. I put on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term, bronchoscopy, biopsy. It'll give you a code range, 31625 to 31629 and 31623 to 31633. Your next step is to double check this code in the tabular list and you should find 31622, bronchoscopy, resist or flexible, including fluoroscopic guidance when performed, diagnostic, with cell washing when performed. 31628, this is an identical, and that is why I have to show you its pairing code, 31622, for your reference. This code, 31628, includes all the information from the code above, what is the pairing code. Except, this code also involves the transbronchial lung biopsy, and it is the appropriate code to use in this case. Any diagnostic endoscopy is always included in the surgical endoscopy and not separately reported. Having said that, the correct answer for this question is 31628. Just a friendly reminder that if you enjoy from what you have learned so far, and appreciate my time spent for this video, then you could please pause the video, click the like, subscribe, and share buttons below now to support my channel. And that would be great. You may or may not know that I'm working full time, and I spend lots of time over the weekend to prepare for this learning video instead of spending time with my family. I really want you to do well with your exam and also for work. I've never asked you for anything in return. And everything that I have done for you is free. So I don't think it is too much to ask for your support. What I give you here is my knowledge and 20 plus years of hospital coding experience. My skill and knowledge are in demand and I can work around the clock. But I decided to spend my time and make these videos for you, just so you know. Thank you so much for your support. And we should move on to the next question. Question number 7. When a bronchoscopy is performed under fluoroscopic guidance, how are the codes assigned per CPT coding guidelines? A. The fluoroscopy guidance code is assigned as a secondary procedure code with the bronchoscopy code. B. The fluoroscopy guiding code is assigned at the first procedure code. C. The fluoroscopy is included in the bronchoscopy and no code is assigned for it. And D. Individual hospital coding guidelines determine whether the fluoroscopy is separately coded. I give you 50 seconds to let me know what should be the correct answer for this question. Your time starts now. Alright, if you pick C, you got it. That's great. I know you pay attention. From the previous question, you already know. 31622, bronchoscopy, rigid or flexible, including fluoroscopic guidance when performed, diagnostic with washing when performed. That said, the fluoroscopy is included in the bronchoscopy and no code is assigned for it. Question number 8. What is the correct CPT code to use for the procedure? Direct laryngoscopy with vocal cord stripping using the operating microscope. I book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term, laryngoscopy, direct. It gives you a code range 31515 to 31571. Your next step is to review these codes in the tabular list and hear what you should get. 31540, laryngoscopy, direct, operative. With excision of tumor and or stripping of vocal cord or epiglottis. And 31541, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the coverable. 31540, what is the parent code? Except 31541 is performed with the operating microscope or telescope. And this is the appropriate code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer for this question is 31541. Question number 9. What is the correct CPT code to use for the procedure? Open Cutwell Lute procedure of maxillary sinuses. You can tell by looking at this image. Cutwell Lute procedure. Use an external approach. An incision is made between the upper lip and gums, and a bony window is made, creating an opening into the maxillary sinuses. I book on a short 30-second music while waiting for you to open your CPT book and find the right code for this procedure. Please pause the video and do it now. Alright, let's see how you did. In the index in your CPT book, you look under the main term Cutwell Lute procedure. It will direct you to see sinus, sinuses, maxillary, expiration. Follow the instruction. You see the code range 31020 to 31032. Now, one word of caution is that under the term maxillary, you will see cartwheel root operation and it gives you one code, 21385. However, if you look up this code in a tabular list, 21385 is for open treatment of orbital floor blowout fracture transanterior approach. And it has nothing to do with this question. In order to use this code, the patient had to be presented with an orbital fracture. That said, I want you to write a note in the index next to code 21385. This code is for orbital fracture. Now, go back to our question. From the instruction, you look under the main term, sinus maxillary exploration. It gives you a code range 31020 to 31032. Your next step is to check these codes in the tabular list. And after reviewing this code, you find 31020 sinusotomy, maxillary, enterotomy, intranasal. And 31030, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above 31020, which is the parent code, except this code 31030 is for radical cartwheel root approach without removal of anterocoanal polyps, and it is the appropriate code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer for this question is 31030. Question number 10. This is a multiple choice question, so you need to follow my tips and strategy. You don't read the procedure report first, simply because you don't have enough time. And also, you may or may not have a clue what you're reading. Therefore, you always start with the answer A, B, C, and D first. This is my backward approach, and I am the only one who tackle case study this way. As you know, many people who watch my videos and follow my tips and strategy have passed the CBC exam successfully. You can read their comments under each video. Let's follow my tip and strategy. A, B, C, and D's all have different codes. 32482, 32484, 32670, and 32671. So they are in the separate groups. Now, all you have to do is pause the video, open your CBT book, and look up this code. Please do it now. Assuming you already looked them up in your CBT book and hear what you got. 32482, removal of lung other than pneumonectomy, two lobes, or bilobectomy. 32484, removal of lung other than pneumonectomy, single segment, or segmentectomy. Because 32067 and 32671 are identical, so I want to show you its parent code. 32601, thoracoscopy, diagnostic lung pericardial sac, mediastinal or pleural space without biopsy. 32670, this is an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above. 32601, which is the parent code, except 32670 is done with a removal of two lobes by lobectomy, thoracoscopically. 32671, this is also an identical, so it includes all the information from the code above. 32601, which is the parent code, except this code is done with removal of lung, pneumonectomy, thoracoscopically. Follow my tips and strategy. You highlight the key difference between these codes, and when you're done, you should have an idea what your focus should be when you start reading the procedure report. You can tell the first two codes are for open procedure and the last two calls are for endoscopy procedure, in other words, thoracoscopy. Also, the difference between 3-4-A2 and 3-4-A4 is that 3-4-A2 is a removal of two lobes of the lung, and 3-4-A4 is for segmentectomy, which is to remove just a section of the lobe of the lung. It also called segmental resection. I already talked about this at the beginning of this video. On the same note, the only difference between 3-6-7-0 and 3-6-7-1 is that 3-6-7-0 is removal of two lobes thoracoscopically, and 3-6-7-1 is a removal of one lung pneumonectomy thoracoscopically. Now is the time for you to read the procedure report. Patient has lung cancer in his lower right and middle lobes. Patient in the operating suite to have a video-assisted thoracoscopy surgery, VATS. A thoracoscope is inserted in the right pleural cavity. Lung was deflated. The tumor is in the right pleural. Both lobes were removed thoracoscopically. A chest tube was placed to suction and patient was sent to recovery in stable condition. Which CPT code is reported for this procedure? You already know the difference between each CPT code and also highlighted the key elements in the procedure report. I'll give you 15 seconds to let me know what should be the right code to use for this procedure. Your time starts now. If you pick C, 3-6-7-0, congratulations, you are the expert now, good for you. The removal of the lobes are performed thoracoscopically, not by an open approach, so you can eliminate A and B. C and D still remain, and based on what you highlighted, both lobes were removed by an endoscope, in other words, thoracoscopically, so 3-6-7-0 is the appropriate code to use for this procedure. That said, the correct answer for this question is 3-6-7-0. That is all for today. Thank you so much for watching, for liking and sharing this video. If you find this video helpful, informative and easy to learn with this format, or if you have any suggestion, then please leave me a comment below just to let me know. I really appreciate. Also, the more positive comments that you leave for me, the better chance for my video will be reviewed by other people. So please continue to do so. Until next time, have a great day.